Good morning, students. I welcome all of you for the BSc 1 microbiology class. We have really selected a very good subject this year, which is very interesting as well as application point of view. It is very good subject and the scope is also a good one. It has a wide scope and lot of applications in various fields in this years. So I am Mrs. Swati Kulkarni. I am going to deal with this paper number 1 from this unit. So firstly we will discuss the syllabus for this semester. I just give you the brief introduction and then we will start in detail all the topics we will discuss later on. So, in this particular year, just you have to study introduction to microbiology. You have to discuss the scope of microbiology as well as the contributions of different scientists for the development of microbiological science. Just I am introducing the subject and then we will discuss regarding the syllabus. I will give you the syllabus for this semester. Just we will introduce means what is covered actually in microbiology. It is a science which deals with the study of small organisms. Small organisms in the sense those organisms which we can't see with our naked eye. They are very small in size. So in this particular subject, we are studying regarding the small organisms, their features, morphological features, structural, biochemical features, antigenic characters, different types we are studying here, and their applications. So it is a branch of science which is almost applicable in variety of fields as well as in research areas. Now you know very well globally the problem is there, the pandemic situation of this coronavirus is there. So you might be knowing corona is the ultimately virus, means it is the type of microorganism. So you may understand the importance now only. It is not necessary to discuss the importance of this subject. But in this particular period, in 7 to 8 months, the problem is going on, the pandemic situation is there due to coronavirus, and this virus is ultimately microorganism. So you now well understand that how this science is important, how much it is important and why to study microbiology. So it also deals with the study of pathogens, means not only the organisms which are useful but those organisms which are harmful to us, these are pathogenic organisms. Means microbiology deals with the study of that organisms which are harmful as well as which are useful also. So it deals with the study of pathogenic microorganism. Pathogenic means those organisms which are causing diseases, those organisms which are causing infections. So we also discuss in this subject regarding the pathogens, regarding those organisms which are industrially important. Some microorganisms are really useful to humankind because we employ this microorganism for industrial purpose in various industries in order to produce commercially the typical products, for example ethanol, alcohol, lactic acid, vaccines, pharmaceutical products. All these are industrially developed or industrially important products. So to produce these products, we use certain kinds of microorganisms. We are using certain strains of microorganism. So this also we are studying in this subject. Secondly, the study of microbiology help us in understanding the various microflora on our body as well as in environment and their interaction. Those organisms, they are present in environment. The organisms are present in air, soil, water as well as on our body also. So everywhere the organisms are present. In soil or in agriculture microbiology, which is a branch of microbiology actually, in this particular branch we will discuss regarding those organisms which are useful to farmers. Means these organisms which are present in soil, they interact with each other, and due to which they are helping to improve the fertility of the soil so that the nitrogen content will be increased, and in this way that will influence the yielding, high yield of this crop. So that is the soil microbiology, or these organisms which are helping for the farmers. These are useful organisms. So interaction of the organism is also useful to us. So we will study in microbiology the interaction of this microorganism, which is also useful to us, and we can apply our knowledge of microbiology in various fields to understand certain new concept as well as for the betterment of humankind. Betterment of humankind in the sense, whenever we are using our knowledge in the medical field especially, we can understand the type of the organism which is going to infect the person, which infection is there, how to isolate the organism, what characters are there of the pathogenic organism. Accordingly, we can give the treatment to the person. So it means that unless and until we can understand the type of the microorganism, unless and until we can study the pathogenic organism in detail, we can't give the treatment. We can't cure particular infection or diseases. So for this purpose, we must have knowledge regarding the organisms, regarding the pathogenic or infectious microorganism. They may be bacteria, they may be virus, they may be fungi, they may be parasite, what it may be. So we should know regarding the pathogenic characters of this type of microorganism. All this comes under microorganism. Bacteria, virus, fungi, algae, protozoa, all this comes under type of microorganism. It is applicable to this science, microbiological science, is applicable to soil analysis as well as water analysis, as well as in medical field, in industrial area, research field, as well as for preparation of the food and preservation of the food also, as well as in dairy industry and biotechnology. So it means that microbiology, or you can say the scope is very wide. The scope is large, and you can say almost is having a wide scope. Microbiology is having the wide scope. Means what? It can be applied in various areas. It can be applied in various fields. It can apply to dairy industry. It may be applied to food industry. It may be applied to industries to produce certain products. It can apply to soil analysis, means related with the agriculture field. It can be applied to medical field definitely, as well as for water analysis. Whenever we know that the soil analysis, water analysis, it is very important. Whenever we think that the water is pure or not pure, whenever water is fit for consumption or not, whether water should be drink or not, so before that the water analysis or water testing is necessary. So in that water testing lab also we can use microbiological science. Unless and until we are having the knowledge of microbiology, we cannot test soil sample or water sample. Remember, similarly in the medical field, as I said, to understand pathogens, to study pathogens and to cure different diseases, to study the virulence power of the microorganism, so everything related with the pathogenic organism, it comes under medical microbiology. Similarly, in research area, whenever we have to discover any new type of the drug, whenever we want to discover any type of the medicine or antibiotic, or whenever the new infectious agent infect the person like coronavirus and other type of the virus, then it is must to study this type of the microorganism, because we want to cure. Nowadays you might have understood that some companies, they are preparing vaccines against the coronavirus. So vaccine also, preparation of the vaccine also comes under medical microbiology. So vaccine is also prepared from infectious agent. it is alive or attenuated. So for this purpose, we should have knowledge regarding the type of microorganism, whether the infectious agent is bacteria or virus. So depending upon that, we can prepare that. So this is one type of the application. Biotechnology, you know very well, it is a one of the new and developing science. In biotechnology, you can discuss regarding the genetic engineering technique as well as different type of the crops are there which are produced by genetic engineering technology, that is hybrid type of variety of plants can be produced, that comes under biotechnology. So you might have heard regarding the BT cotton. So BT cotton, this is the one of the cotton variety which is having the high yield of cotton as well as it is resistant to disease, and therefore this variety is having a lot of demand, and therefore this variety can be produced by only biotechnological science or by genetic engineering technology only, and this is one of the application. So we can apply our knowledge of microbiology to soil analytical laboratory or soil analysis, water analysis, research field, medical field, industrial area, biotechnology and dairy industry. Dairy industry means whenever we produce different milk products from milk. So before the production and before the selling of this milk as well as milk products, the milk which is the raw material or the milk which is obtained from farmers and is collected in dairy, this milk is also tested microbiologically. So microbiological analysis of milk is primarily done in order to check the microbial load on the milk sample, means how much or what is the percentage of microorganism originally present in the raw milk sample. If the microorganism content is high, that is considered to be very poor quality. So if it is low, it is considered to be good quality of milk, because we know milk get easily spoiled. If we do not take proper precaution, it get easily spoiled. Therefore, it is necessary to test the milk sample before it is sold in the market, how much the or what is the quality of milk, how much microbial load is there. So that comes under milk microbiology. So this is regarding the applications. Then I will give you the syllabus for paper number 1 in this semester 1. So this is CBCS, or it is already changed syllabus, it is not changed now. So in unit 1, just I will give you the brief idea, and then I will give details of the syllabus. I will send you on WhatsApp. So unit 1, it covers history and milestones in microbiology. So here you can discuss what is the scope, as I said now, and different contributions of the scientist as well as spontaneous generation theory. So contributions of scientist, few scientists you have to study, not all. So the contributions include contributions of Antony von Leeuwenhoek, contributions of Louis Pasteur, contributions of Robert Koch, Ivanovsky, Joseph Lister, Alexander Fleming, Vinogradsky. So this is regarding the contributions. Then secondly, beneficial and harmful activities of microorganism. Here also you have to study the classification of microorganism by Whitaker's system, 5 kingdoms of classification and features of classification, means how microorganisms are classified, what is the basic thing, what is the basic concept here which is used, that part you have to discuss here, and general principles of bacterial nomenclature. Nomenclature means how to give the names. So we know in botany and in zoology also, you might have discussed botanical name, zoological name. Certain plants are given botanical name, zoological name, but they are not convenient or they are not easy for the use in day-to-day purpose or in practical purpose, but they are useful whenever we want to study each and every plant or animal in detail biologically, then it is necessary. Similarly, here also the bacteria are given the name, including genus and species. So that is includes in the general principle of nomenclature, which includes the binomial classification and taxonomical ranks also. You have to study means genus, species, family, order, class, kingdom, etc. So the whole taxonomical levels, all the taxonomical ranks, you have to study in this classification topic and scope of microbiology. Scope means how it is applied and where it is, where we can apply our knowledge on in various fields. The second unit includes stains and procedures, staining techniques and microscopy. So you might have in 12th and have used particular stain like eosine, sometimes you have used bithrin blue, like that. So why we use stains and what is the basic difference between the dye and stain? Because both are coloring agent, but dye we are using for textile purpose and stains we are using for biological purpose. So what is the difference between stain and dye? That difference we can study here. Different type of stains you will discuss: acidic stain, basic stain, neutral stain, and different staining procedures, means monochrome staining, ground staining, acid fast staining, negative staining, cell wall staining, capsule staining, like that. So different type of the staining procedures you can study here: simple staining, negative staining, differential staining, their examples, and special staining including cell wall, capsule, and volutin granule, like that. So volutin granule is not there, cell wall and capsule, so which is the part of the cell. It means that for the to observe the specific parts of the cell, how we can stain only that particular part by using special stain and special staining procedure also. So that is including stains and staining procedures, as well as we will discuss here the mechanism of staining, because why this particular stain is there, why we observe the bacteria blue, pink in color, or this pink in color or violet in color. So that mechanism we will discuss here in staining procedure and mechanism. Then we will discuss in the same unit regarding the microscopy, general principles of microscopy. So as I said earlier that we are studying microbiology, and microbiology deals with the study of microorganism, means which we can't study or which we can't see with our naked eye. We need microscope in order to demonstrate them. So here we will study regarding the principles of microscopy, different types of microscopes we are studying here, that how these microscopes are constructed, what type of different lens system is used here, then basic parts of the microscope including the, that means pillar as well as objective, eyepiece, like that. You have already observed my microscope, but in this year we are maximum using microscope. Unless and until we have knowledge, we can't observe the object clearly and we can't study the organism in detail. So we should have knowledge of these microscopes also. Then regarding the lens system which are used, the immersion lens, magnification power, resolving power, then regarding the bright field, compound microscope, simple microscope, electron microscope, scanning electron microscope, ACM, and this comparison of light and electron microscope. So what is the, that means different ray diagrams are there. With the help of that, you can study the mechanism of this light transmission. What are different types of lens systems used there? What is resolving power? What is this numerical aperture? As well as what is the importance of scanning electron microscope and the difference between light and electron microscope in detail. So this is regarding the syllabus for this unit and paper 1. So we will discuss from the next lecture the details. So I will deal with the first topic, that is the scope of microbiology, introduction, and the applications. That part we will discuss first, because it is important, as there is a contribution of different scientists for the development of microbiological science. Thank you.